Children, in the last session, we have learnt about the flex sensor. In order to understand the principle of this flex sensor, we shall compare this sensor with a circuit. In this sensor, the resistance value increases or decreases according to the position of the sensor. So, how this happens? Let us compare this with this circuit. In this circuit, several resistors are connected in series. So, what is a serial connection? In a serial connection, we will have one terminal connected to the battery and the another terminal will be connected to the next resistor and its terminal will be connected to the next resistor. So it looks like this. So what happens is the electron flow occurs through this wire and it reaches this resistor and passes through this resistor and it enters to the next resistor through this way. So similarly, it goes through all the resistors connected in the circuit and reaches this LED light and make this light glow. So what happens if we remove any one of the resistors? Can you see this? Now the LED light is not glowing. So what happens is when we connect a serial connection, then every component forms a conductive layer. So if we remove any one of the component, then the circuit is stopped. That is, we will make a open circuit. So in a serial connection, there is only one path, and if we interrupt any of the components, then all the other components will be disturbed. So this is a serial connection. And similarly, we have a serially connected terminals over here. So these golden color parts are the conductive layers and the black colored layers are the non-conductive layers. So what happens is when we bend the sensor like this, the conductive layers separated by this non-conducting layer will get close to each other. So since the conductive layers are getting closer to each other, the conductivity is increased and the resistivity is decreased. Similarly, in this circuit, the resistance over here will increase between these two terminals. That is, the total resistance between this point and this point is very high. But if we check individually, each resistor will have a specific resistance value. So when we connect something in series, what happens is the total resistance is very high. So if we remove this and change the endpoint and connect it over here, what will happen is the resistance will decrease. For each terminal, the resistance will decrease and will make more glow in the LED light, because The serial connection of resistors will form a voltage dividing circuit. So what is a voltage dividing circuit? Let us check it now. In order to check the voltage, we need a multimeter. So this is a device and it will show us the voltage values between any two points. So it will have a area over here. It will show us the DC voltage, that is the voltage that we obtain from batteries and some electronic circuits. So in order to get the voltage, we need to choose the specified voltage range. So currently we are using a 4 volt battery. Can you see this? It is a 4 volt battery. So the voltage we are using is nearly 4 volt. So we are choosing 20 volt. Then we can view the values that are between 0 to 20 volt. Now we have connected this 4 volt battery through these resistors and the LED light is also connected in series. Now let us check the voltage between each point in this circuit. So first I am checking the voltage between this resistors. So the voltage at resistor 1 is 0.01. so this is a very minimum value, and let us check on the next resistor. So this resistor is consuming 0.42 volt. So let us this is little higher, and let us check. Now this resistor is also consuming 0.4 volt. And we will check on the next resistor. So now we have checked several resistors and each resistor is showing a different value. So if we check over here, it is showing 0.42 volt. So these four resistors are consuming 0.4 volt each, and this resistor is consuming 0.01 volt. So this resistor is consuming a very less value and all these resistors are consuming 0.4 volt. So if we add these four values, that is 0.4 plus 0.4 plus 0.4 plus 0.4, then what will be the output of these four resistors? Let us check it over here. Can you see this? It is showing nearly 1.7. so this is the total voltage consumed by all these four resistors. Okay, let us check the voltage consumed by this LED light. Can you see that? It is consuming nearly 1.4 volt. And it rises up. It is showing nearly more than 2 volt. So the voltage consumed by this LED is an average of 2.1 volt. So in this circuit, the voltage is divided by each component connected in series. And hence, if we want to reduce voltage in a circuit, we can add several components in series so that each component will absorb certain value of voltage according to its property. So each component consumes certain value of voltage, and if we require a certain value of voltage, then we need to add components in series so that we can get our required voltage. For example, currently we have a 4 volt battery, but we can get only 0.4 volt between these two terminals. So if we require 0.4 volt, then we can make a circuit like this and get 0.4 volt alone from this circuit. Okay, how this works with the flux sensor? Similarly, the flux sensor is also a voltage dividing circuit, so that whenever we bend the sensor, the voltage is increased. That is, physically this terminal is moved over here. Can you understand this? If this terminal is moved over here, then the voltage in the circuit will be high. That is, the resistance is decreased and the voltage is increased. Okay, we can check this now. So now I have connected only 3 resistors and an LED light in this circuit. Now I am going to check the voltage between these two points, that is the voltage consumed by this LED light. Now can you see this, children? This same resistor is now consuming 0.56 volt, which is much higher than the previously measured value. This is because now we have reduced the number of resistors. So what happens is, the voltage, that is the 4 volt, is now shared between these 3 resistors and this LED light. So what happens is, the input source is same 4 volt, but the components are reduced. Similarly, when we bend the circuit, the conductivity is increased by reducing the distance between each conductive element. So the voltage consumed is reduced and the output voltage will be high. Okay children, now in this session we have learned how to divide the voltage and get the required voltage from the source voltage. So we can now get only 0.4 volt or even lesser voltage from a high voltage circuit using a series of resistors. And also we understand that this sensitive element also uses resistors to provide us a value of the bend in the surface. Okay children, we will meet in the next session. Thank you.